initially, like the first one was like finding A complement. It's very simple. And B complement I wasn't to you people. Now let's get into the third problem in this. So how do you find this A union C whole complement? So this is nothing but U minus A union C. So A union C whole complement is equal to, don't write the things directly, just mention it by step by step. Now this is universal setting, like you got 4 and then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then what is this A union C? This is needed, because it's not mentioned directly. So before that, let me find out what is called A union C. So A union C is nothing but, first you just mention what is set A there. It is 1, 2, 3, 4 union with set C. What is set C there? 3, 4, 5, 6. So A union C is nothing but, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these are the elements which are present in A union C. So when you know what is called A union C, you can just find out what is A union C whole dash. So now by knowing what is called A union C whole dash will be equal to, you can just write this here, U minus A union C. Then you get 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, minus. What is A union C? It is mentioned as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that's what we got as A union C there. Now, A union C whole dash. So, repeatedly, like I'm telling you, A dash is nothing but you are going to list out the elements which are not present in A. Set A, all of the elements for you. B dash is nothing but excluding the elements which are present, which are, I mean, that we are going to list out the elements which are not present in B, only present in U. The same thing with A union C whole dash. When I say A union C whole complement, you are going to list out the elements which are not present in A union C. Okay. So not present in A union C, excluding, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what are the elements you got? 7, 8, then 9. Like I have seen so many students, they are writing this A union C or directly, because there is no such formula or something, like it's a, not a big thing. But still you people should write that set A mentioned clearly, then set C, then what is that operation you are going to perform, union or intersection, do that properly. Like you will have steps for each and every step. I mean, either probably you will have, for writing this formula you will have 1 mark. For writing what is called set A and union with C, after performing that you'll have 1 mark. So marks are allotted for each step, so it is mandatory to mention each and every step clearly there. Okay, so one more way of solving this problem is you just take the screenshot, and I'm going to keep the recorded video. So A union C whole dash can also be written as, so in the last class I have explained something about De Morgan's law. So for any two non-empty sets, say A and B, A union B whole dash, in the sense A union B whole complement, it will be again equal to A complement intersection B complement. See, when I write some expression, this is equal to this andaga, so this will be true for any sets you take A and B. The other red set, you perform this operation. First you perform what is called A union B. Then you perform the complement for A union B. You will be getting something in the LHS part. Then you perform what is called A complement. You know how to perform A complement. Then you perform B complement. Make the intersection of these two. Then the solutions for these two. In the sense, set same part, same. Okay. So same thing. A union C whole dash now. I can perform in this way, or I can just write A union C whole dash as something called A dash intersection C dash. Okay, so instead of finding A union C, then finding A union C whole dash, you can find out what is called A dash, you can find what is called C dash, and perform the intersection. Maybe it takes another 2 or 3 extra steps. Okay. Suppose, why I am telling this is, suppose in the question if it is given A dash, let me put this in this A dash complement formula. If A dash set is given, B dash set is given to you, okay, with some elements, finite set, okay, Suppose if the question is like, perform what is called A union C whole dash. Some universal set, if it is not mentioned, usually complement is the invention matter. If it is not mentioned, how do you perform this A union C whole dash? Like you can be like dilemma. Where is that A, where is that C, and how to perform A union C, all these questions will arise. So adakke nimge De Morgan's law gotirbeku. A union C whole dash, when A dash and B dash are given, how do you find that? This is again nothing but A dash in intersection with C dash. Let me say this is C dash. That's it. Okay. So you need to know this information. This is the third problem in that. Now the fourth one is, so it's a very simple one. Like they have asked, what is A union B whole complement? So exactly similar to the third one. So instead of C, you have B. So fourth one you maadbeku. Fifth one nodri. So what is it? A complement whole complement. So it's not like these two things will get cancelled. No, there's nothing like theory of indices here. There is no such cancellation. So if you perform complement to the whole complement, it will again be equal to set A. This is a property. Okay. Then last class alle I have given the notes and given some properties. Properties andra artha eno, it holds good anta artha. You imagine any set. You imagine any arbitrary set. Maybe like you are interested in taking natural numbers. I am interested in taking some odd natural numbers, maybe even natural numbers. Somebody takes some other set. Adalla. So for all those sets, U property, it will hold good. Okay. So when I have seen so many students cancelling this complement, there is nothing like cancelling. As I said, you cannot apply the basic arithmetic, operations like you got addition, subtraction, multiplication, no, prohibited. So you cannot cancel it. A complement to the whole complement is again nothing but set A. Directly you can write it, or else you can just perform that. Ignore it. A complement to the whole complement. Now you are applying complement to the A complement. So first let me find out what is A complement there. It's a very clear straight question. A complement is nothing but this is U then minus A. Okay. So A complement is like we have 1, 2, 3 up to 9 elements for universal set. Then we got set A. What is set A there? 1, 2, 3 and then 4. Then finally A complement is nothing but 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. These are the elements which are not present in A. Okay? Now coming to A complement to the whole complement. So means you are applying complement to the complement. Okay. So don't put what is called theory of indices properties here. Okay. So now this can be written as U minus of A dash. A is nothing but U minus A. A dash whole dash is nothing but U minus A dash. Now what is set U there? You got like 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 9 elements. Minus what is A dash? A complement. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now this is nothing but the elements excluding 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. What are the elements you got? So you have 1, 2, 3, then 4. Is it not again the set A? Where is that? Yes. Okay. So it's like you have made it humongous. Like you have performed what is called A dash, then A dash whole dash. These are not necessary. If you just remember what is called the property A dash whole dash, this is again equal to A, the game is over in just one step. Okay. Because these are problems which they'll give for one mark. One mark, these are not necessary. If you don't know the property, in math A dash mark, is it necessary to perform all these things for one mark? No, adilla. So I suggest you to remember this property. Sir, notes are name baribeku, I mean whether to follow this steps and all. No, just write as we know that A dash to the whole dash is again nothing but A, and you can simply just write down what is set here. That's it. Okay. So this is solution for question 5 in that. So coming to the last one, question 6. So you got B minus C whole dash, B minus C whole complement. So as I said to you, this chapter is actually like 1 mark, 2 marks, istake either the range. Don't expect too much from this chapter. Maybe like introduction online only, people should get adjusted with everything. So I did not get into the actual part of mathematics. So in the actual part start agade what is called relations and functions. Ali you get so many things, trigonometry entry after the. And then when I take up relations and functions, next comes coordinate geometry. Okay, so you basic things are at least you need to have clarity. Ignore it. B minus C whole complement. You know how to find B minus C whole complement? It's like performing U minus of the set. See, whatever may be the set, don't worry whether you got minus, you got intersection, you got union, or something else. This something to the whole complement. Let me just put this in this way. Something whole complement is nothing but U minus of that something. Maybe it's a simple one, but still, like B minus C whole complement. Whether you write this as U minus B minus C, now you just go wrong in all these things. You just put the brackets. It makes good sense actually. B minus C is complete one set. You should just put entire thing within the brackets. If you don't put the bracket, means you don't have a good knowledge on what is called sets anta artha. It looks very odd, right? U minus B minus C means you are putting everything in one box. Universal set anade bere, B minus C ano sette bere. Between these two sets you are performing something. Means you have, there must be some differentiation. This is one set, this is the second set. Okay, so now how do you perform this? U minus B minus C. The first, let me just perform B minus C. How do you find B minus C? Just don't do all these calculations. I mean, things here, just write down everything. B, this is 2, 4, 6, 8 minus C. This is 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, B minus C is nothing but you got 2 here, you don't have that in the next set, just mention. Then 4, you have then 6, you have then what about 8? No, 2, 8. Okay, this is a very simple one. Now coming to complement, now this becomes U then minus B minus C. Is it the right way to do that? Will you get any sense that what are the two sets here if you write something like this? Because majority will be writing like U minus B minus, and don't put all this mathematics here, minus into minus. No, there is nothing like science alone aniga, that's the least bothered about that. I'm bothering about what is called operations. So what are the two sets? This is the one set, this is the second set. Okay, just put some bracket, you will have the good sense. You will get correct agothide anadu goda. What is it? Universal set. Mention it. So you got 1, then 2, 9 elements minus B minus C. What's a B minus C? 2, 8. Then excluding 2, 8. What are the elements you have? So you got something called 1, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. That's it. This becomes what's called B minus C whole complement. You may get it for 2 marks, maybe. Okay. So thereby we have completed the first problem. These are very simple. Any doubts in this? Thank you, my friend. Oh. What's that? Any problem you are facing? Don't worry, I'm going to put the recorded video. Friends, please stop texting. No sir, everything is board is not clear. Is it clear? Thank you. Okay. So see, one thing, nimge yenra board clarity illa antandre matte I'm helpless, because nan wifi al maartidini. Nan the problem in rangilla, maybe from your side. So nan as I said you record maartidini, I'm going to upload it. Class at next half an hour I'll do that. Now, in that time?
15 minutes only.
Okay. Now, let's get into the next, second one. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ನೀವು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್, ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಒನ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ನೀವು ಮಾಡಿರಿ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ ರಿಪೀಟೆಡ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲನೇಷನ್. ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಡಿ ಇ ಆರ್ ಜಿ ಆರ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ಯು. ಫೈಂಡ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್, ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಎ, ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿ, ಸೆಟ್ ಸಿ, ಸೆಟ್ ಡಿ. All these are given. The question is like you have to perform what is called A dash, B dash, C dash and then D dash. These are the things which you have to do in the second problem. So you have to complete that second one. ನಿಮಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರೂ ಡೌಟ್ ಬಂತು ಅಂದರೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ ಮೀ, ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಫಿಲ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕೇಳ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಲ್ಲ, ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಏನಿಲ್ಲ, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಯು ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಸೊ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಸೈನ್ ಟು ಯು, ನೀವು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್, taking the set of natural numbers as the universal set, write down the complements of the following sets. It's clearly mentioned. So there are some 10 11 problems are given to you. For all those 11 problems you have to consider natural numbers as a universal set. By taking natural numbers as universal set, you have to perform the complements of individual sets. Pratyondu sets the complements barita hogtirbeku, that is the question. Okay, now let me just take up that universal set. So universal set is like you got natural numbers. See, as it is like infinite set, I just put this in set builder form instead of writing in roster form. Other, and one more, like you need to have this basic sense. When the set is finite, ಆದಷ್ಟು ನೀವು ಸೆಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆಯೋಕ್ಕೆ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ಡೋಂಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಿಶ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ರೋಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ರಾಂಗ್, ಬಟ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ 3 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ 1, ಡ್ಯಾಶ್. ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹೌದಾ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಲುಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ದ 3 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ 3 ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಂಡೇಟರಿ, ಅದು ಬರಲೇಬೇಕು. So that's why I suggest you to write the things in what is called set builder form when it is infinite. When the set is infinite, mention that in set builder form. Okay, so you got x is a natural number. No conditions, nothing, no inequalities.
10 minutes.
Okay, that's okay. Okay. ಸೊ ಈಗ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ನಾನೊಂದು ಐ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಕವರ್ ಸಮ್ 4-5 ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ವೆರಿ ಸಿಲಿ, ಏನು ದೊಡ್ಡ, ನಿಮಗೆ ನೋ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್, ಭಾಳ ಸಿಂಪಲಾಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಲೈಕ್ ದ ಹವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಸಮ್ ರಾ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿತೌಟ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಹೌದಾ. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೋಟ್ಸ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್ ಬಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು, ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು, ಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್ ಟು, ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಗೆ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ರಾ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್. ಮೇ ಬಿ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಸಮ್ 4-5 ಆರ್ ಸಿಂಪಲ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಿಲ್ಲ. ಇನ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾನೆ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೋ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಬಿಫೋರ್ ದಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಚ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ 11 ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಇನ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಈಗ ವೆನ್ ಐ ಸೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಗ್ರೇಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ 3, let me explain. This is maybe in one or two problems it is given inequalities, but you need to know certain basics. And one more thing is like you are going to learn this in a chapter called linear inequations, inequalities, and you are going to learn all the properties and everything in that. But illi nimge basic helkodtini ashte, I'll just cover that in two points. You can add or subtract anything on both sides, that's a first point. Clear? You can add or subtract anything on both sides. Maybe if you have something like x plus 3 is greater than 0. Now we have to find what is called x, where x is from. So what I do is I want to eliminate this plus 3. How do you eliminate plus 3 there? Eng eliminate martire? Subtracting 3 on both sides. So what happens? X plus 3 minus 3 greater than 0 minus 3 is what? Minus 3. Then these two get cancels. Then x is greater than minus 3 and you can make out. So as you don't have equal to here, it becomes open. When you have equal to, it becomes closed. So open minus 3 to where? It goes up to infinity. So minus 3 to infinity, x belongs to. Does it look like property actually? Very simple thing. You can add or subtract anything on both sides. Just you remember this. The very important is you can multiply and divide anything on both sides. But the point to be noted is like when you are multiplying or dividing a negative thing on both sides, then the sign of the inequality changes. Because plus 2 and minus 2, it makes a different sense. Like 2 ito, when you are multiplied with a negative sign, 2 has become minus 2. It gives out different thing. Adukage, the sign of the inequality changes. Greater than, it becomes less than. So when I say minus x greater than something like 5, what is x ranges from? Trial and error method of what happens when I give 0, what happens when I give 1, what happens when I give 5. No need to put that. Just remember these basic properties. I need to get x. Minus is there. I should eliminate minus. How I should eliminate minus sign? By multiplying minus 1 on both sides. So when you are multiplying by negative sign or dividing by negative sign, the sign of the inequality changes. So now this becomes minus of minus is plus. Then greater than symbol becomes less than. 5 into minus 1 becomes minus 5. As you can observe, minus 5 to minus infinity. So minus 5 to minus infinity. I am not talking about how to find the solutions and all. Basic things here put it in the last time. Okay. So this is about the inequality. There's so much to learn about inequations and all. So you'll be you'll come across in the third or the fourth chapter. In the first year, I'll say that. Thereby, in the next class, I'll be dealing with question 3 and I'm going to complete this in the next class. Exercise 1.5 mugitade. Exercise 1.5 mugitandre, you are coming out from the easy zone. You got all lily things. Onthara performing union, performing intersection, complement. Namgu experiment ag bejar anisthitu. Now you're getting into the actual part. Exercise 1.5 aadmale, you got word problems where you have to jog your brains. Salpa, little bit of exercise, remembering formula, performing with the Venn diagrams. All these things will come to. We'll take up that third problem in the next class. Okay, just complete 1 and 2. In detail, I have explained this. Maybe I can do this in 5 minutes. But I've just explained what are the possible mistakes you'll be committing. Tomorrow I can't do all these things. Tomorrow I'll straight away get into the problem and I'll just finish off this. Okay, thank you.